Hey there, and welcome. I'm Ganesh from LearnEnglishLab.com, and in this lesson, we're going to talk about the difference between the words house and home. Now, I know that these two words sound similar, but there's a very important difference between them. And that difference is that the word house refers to a building where people live, and it refers to some physical aspect of the building. But the word home talks generally about where you live or where someone lives. Let me give you some examples. When we say they live in a big house, we are talking about the size of the house. Or if we say the house is on Fifth Street, then we're talking about the location of the house. In both of those sentences, size and location are physical aspects of the building. That's why we're using the word house. But consider this example. When we say, I want to go home, the focus is not on the building where we live. In fact, if I say, I want to go home, my home could be a house, or it could be an apartment in an apartment complex. Or maybe I live in a truck. Some people do that. Some people live in these mobile or movable homes. They're called trailers, and they're attached to trucks. So if I live in a trailer, then that's my home. Or I might live on a boat, and that would be my home. So when I say I want to go home, I'm talking simply about the place where I go back to at the end of the day. So in that way, it shows a physical, a personal or emotional connection to that place. And the focus is not on any physical aspect of the building. So here's a simple guideline. If you want to talk generally about where you live, or you want to show your connection to the place, then use the word home. But if you want to talk about some physical aspect of the building, then use the word house. All right, let's now do some practice sentences to really make sure we understand this concept. I have here four sentences. Take a look at the first sentence. Our is being painted. Would you write house or home in the sentence? Well, if you read the sentence carefully, you see that we're talking about something being painted. And painting is a physical action. And painting is usually done on a building. So here we need the word house. So our house is being painted. In the second example, you can take my car today and bring it back tomorrow. Well, in this sentence, if we say house, it's going to seem a little strange. If I say, you can take my car to your house and bring it back tomorrow. People say that sometimes, and that's a common error that some students make. In that case, it sounds a little strange because the focus is not on the building. We simply want to say, take my car with you and then bring it back tomorrow. So here we're looking for the word home. So you can take my car home and bring it back tomorrow. Notice here that we're not saying to your home. When we use the word home, we normally don't use to. We just say, you can take my car home and bring it back tomorrow. All right, sentence number three is, when I get from work, I just like to lie on the couch and watch TV. House or home? Once again, we're looking for the word home. Why? Because when I talk about getting home from work, my home could be anything. It could be that I live in an apartment, or maybe I go back to a trailer where I live, or I go back to my boat. That doesn't matter. I'm simply saying that when I return from work, when I go back to the place where I feel most comfortable, and that's my home. So when I get home from work, I just like to lie on the couch and watch TV. Once again, notice there's no to. Some students make the mistake of saying, when I get to home from work. That's wrong. When I get home. That's all. Right, and in the last example, does Jen live in a or an apartment? In this case, we are talking about the building. And here we're talking about the type of building in which Jen lives. So does Jen live in a house or an apartment? All right, I hope you got all of those correct. And I hope that you can now use the words house and home correctly. Remember to subscribe to this channel, and I'll see you in another lesson soon.